Welcome to the Creating an Empowered Body, Mind, and Life podcast with your host, author, fitness entrepreneur, empowerment and transformation coach, Chris Ellerby-Hemmings. This podcast is about helping people find happiness through health, fitness, and mindset.
So, welcome to the first Empowered Body, Mind, and Life podcast. And today I have an awesome guest for our first episode. This is Tom Mack. In fact, do you want to use your full name?
What's your full name? Tom McMillan is the
Tom
full name.
Tom McMillan. So I didn't know that until we added you on Skype.
MAC.
So this podcast is going to be quite unusual, and we're going to talk about trying to help people find real deep happiness inside themselves. I know that sounds a little bit hippie and a little bit unrealistic, but it's something that I've personally done over a 5-year journey. I know something that Tom's done through some personal development learning and, of course, health and fitness, because that's kind of part of the topic. So if you'd like to maybe introduce yourself, Tom, and we can find out a little bit about you as well.
Brilliant. Well, first of all, hi, everyone, whoever watches us on YouTube, listens on iTunes. Really excited to be on today, and it feels a little bit weird because I'm on the other side of the camera. I'm the one who's being asked questions, so it's a little bit weird, but I look forward to it. So, a little bit about me. I'm 22 years young. I live in North Wales. I have a bachelor's degree in sport and exercise science. I own Bodybymac, which is a body transformation, primarily online coaching, a little bit of one-to-one, but for the most part, it's online. So I've been coaching for around 3 years, 2 years under the name of Bodybymac. I'm a world champion bodybuilder, drug tested, natural, competed in 2014. My first season, I won a few titles, including the Worlds. Took 14 months off, came back to it last year. I came second in a novice heavyweights class with the MPA, and then I came first in the UK BDFA juniors. So, away from that, I've done a little bit of powerlifting, again, drug tested. I got a British record in the deadlift back when I was like 20. So yeah, that's literally about me. I'm a coach, fitness enthusiast, and yeah, that's about it. So thanks for being invited on, and I'm really looking forward to this one.
So that's an awesome intro by Tom there. You've done a hell of a lot. What age are you now, did you say?
What's that, mate?
What age are you now?
22.
So yeah, I missed that bit. So what I'd like to ask you, Tom, is how you think that all of that work around health and fitness, the powerlifting, the bodybuilding, the way you eat and things like that, but more about how all of that has made you feel happier in life. Because that's going to be the main theme of these podcasts.
Yeah, awesome. Well, you know, fitness is a massive part of my life, and, you know, from yourself, and, you know, obviously you're in the industry yourself, and when you're submersed in fitness, so my whole day revolves around fitness. It really does, you know, coaching, personal training, and then obviously my own training. I'm learning and doing things like this, often on the podcast, writing content. You're submersed in fitness, and I enjoy my life. You know, it sounds weird, but I'm happy. I wake up day to day. I know that what I'm doing involves what I'm passionate about. You're going to have days when, yeah, you know, you're going to be tired. You might not want to train. You might have a ton of work to do, and you might feel a little bit overwhelmed. But for the most part, I'm doing something I love, and fitness has made that happen. So getting into fitness, I've always been active, you know, as a young child. I played football, I ran cross country competitively, played a little bit of rugby, wasn't very good. Also did a bit of boxing as well. So, you know, I haven't just done weightlifting, I've been around a variety of sports. And for me, it always just made me happy because I was more kind of physical, hands-on than academic. Funnily enough, I actually went on to do a degree and whatnot. But again, it was tied into fitness. I always came back to fitness, and that is what made me happy. So yeah, you can say being competitive makes me happy. Having control of my body, having control of what I do, sport allows me to do that.
So many, many intellects, so to speak, will say that progression equals happiness. Yeah. Do you think that the progressive mindset that you've developed through the different sports has helped you be happy on a daily basis?
Massively. I have a very addictive personality, Chris, and I think this ties in really well with obviously bodybuilding. being self-employed, if I don't feel like I'm going up, I kind of lose control.
Okay.
And for me, fitness it's always, you know, an outlet for me to progress, whether it's progressive overload in the gym, whether it's adding another trophy to the cabinet, whether it's progressing in business, whether it's progressing socially, it's all progression. And progression is what makes me happy, I think.
Mm.
Fitness, of course, is an outlet which allows me to do that more so than maybe a lot of other things. So yeah, progress definitely makes me happy. Like I said, if
progress
I don't feel like I'm
happiness. Yeah.
Progress equals happiness. You know, if I don't feel like I'm climbing, I kind of feel like I'm regressing.
Mm. There's a story which is good to put in at this point, because a lot of what I do ends up being around coaching people, and I end up doing a lot of speaking events. And one of the stories I bring into the event, it's usually on week five when we do like the last seminar talking about personal development, is this swimming story. So you might have done this yourself, Tom. You might have been at a holiday, or you might have been on the beach, and you know when you can see one of them like islands not so far out, and it's like, yeah, it's quite achievable because it's only just like a little swim away. It might not be the island, it might be like one of them rafts, or it might be a boat that you're going to swim to just to see it. So you're lying on a beach, you kind of prep yourself, you get yourself ready, and then you go swimming towards that goal, the island, the boat, or whatever that is, just out in the sea. So you swim along and you enjoy the journey on the way there. And then what happens if you go stiff in the sea? Well, you're going to sink, right? So that's kind of like stopping still and not going, or not progressing towards your goals, is like going stiff in the sea. And that's like sinking. And that's like sinking. Sometimes some people might sink into a depressive state here, is like the analogy for it. So the idea is that we always keep progressing towards that goal or that island just outside there, whether it's nice slow strokes or whether it's really fast swimming, depending on how quick you want to go to that island or that goal. But then when you arrive there, what do? You get to the island or the boat and you climb on, and then you go, it's only a boat, it's only an island. And that's just sometimes a problem in life, where people get to that goal, or they get to that goal in life. And I know for you, you'll notice the same as me in bodybuilding, is that when you get to the stage the next day or the week after, you have a plummet in motivation because you've not got that goal anymore. It might be the same for somebody in a new job. It might be the same for somebody with a fitness goal, weight loss goal. You might get there and like give up. And this is the idea, is to, in my mindset, from the learning I've done around personal development, is to always progress. So when you get to that island or the goal, you just go, okay, it's just an island, it's just a goal, what's the next thing? And always progress to the next one. And that's what fitness has done for me, is always having the progressive mindset, and a similar to you. So that's kind of how I've developed my kind of happiness, is through progression. What do you reckon about that?
Yeah, I mean, if you said to me, you know, if you're not going to add another pound of muscle to your physique ever, and at 22 years old, yeah, I don't plan on stopping anytime soon, I would still be in the gym 6 days a week, giving it my all and just busting it in there, because it's not getting to the destination. It's the journey there. You know, I'm going to throw this back to 2014. It's my first season. I won a world title, and, you know, I picked up the trophy and I kind of thought, yeah, this is cool. I won a world trophy. I looked at Facebook. Yeah. Notifications. Yeah. That's cool. And then the next day I'm sitting in a pizzeria in Italy thinking, you know, I've already won a world title. What's next? You know, that was enjoyable, but that's next, you know. And then you do go into that kind of state where you're not progressing. So what's the next step as a bodybuilder? Yeah. Again, through fitness, we aim to progress.
Yeah.
Progress the physique. We do the progressive overload. We get the calories high. We progress. We add muscle and we return. So we're always in a journey. And, you know, that is what I love. I love having that journey, because it's never the end goal. It's always the journey, and it's enjoying the journey. Again, because it's just progressing. It's just continually trying to better yourself, and it goes through every walk of life. But again, fitness just allows me to pursue goals through fitness. You know, it allows me to express that competitive edge and that happiness I have, the journey, as it were.
So we've met online, and then we've also met at a Gary Vaynerchuk event down in London one time.
And outside my show.
And at your show, yes. So when we met down, it's strange how you only meet a couple of times actually in person, but I know you quite well. It's like when you a lot of this podcast will accidentally fall into business talk, because a lot of that, especially now in this day and age, you can almost create your own happiness through pursuing a passion in the business or the area of life that you enjoy. So mine happened to be all chips in on health and fitness, the same as yours. Do you think that being all chips in, so to speak, created a lot of your happiness, because that's all you do is fitness now, right?
Well, you know, it's a funny thing. If I wake up tomorrow and I've had enough, I don't want to do these check-ins, I don't want to post content, I don't want to go to the gym, that's it, stops, I'm out of here, I'm setting up a new business, I'm going to work for someone 9-to-5. So
this is really interesting.
That's how I kind of feel about it. When this job, when this industry, when this sport doesn't make me happy, that's when I stop. And then who knows what for me. So if you could just repeat the question just the end bit again, mate.
It was about basically moving towards business as has business helped you be happier, do you think, because it's actually what your passion is at the moment?
Yeah, and again, it's that goal. So you're self-employed, I'm self-employed. If we go down that mindset of, you know, I don't class myself as an entrepreneur as such, but, you know, I'm still self-employed and I'm still doing this for myself. So there's always that pressure when you're self-employed is, I need to earn X amount per month. I want to be in this position next year, in 2 years, in 5 years.
Progression again, right?
Again, progression, and it comes down to that progression. So if you link the two together, is it fitness that makes me happy? Is it earning money that makes me happy? Is it helping people make me happy? Or is it just that one concept of progression through life? And that could be with anything. That could be progressing in relationships. Again, if I start up a new business, is it just progression in that business?
Yeah.
I think, you know, just because I had a passion for sport and health and fitness in the start, and I got into bodybuilding and whatnot, and that's what I really loved, that's why I went down into this industry, really. And again, you know, when I started off, I was confused, and I probably wasn't happy in the early stages, truth be told. I was sick of not seeing results. I was sick of what the magazine said. I was sick of what the big guy on steroids would say in the gym, who, by the way, still looks the same to this day, because I train in the same gym.
that's interesting as well.
Seriously. You know, and I probably wasn't happy back then, but once I started seeing results and I started learning about things, again, progression, because I'm learning. I went to university, I studied a degree in sports science, did my A-levels before that. Again, there's progress here. I finished my degree. I was starting a master's degree in sports and exercise nutrition. I did 4 weeks and I actually pulled out because I wanted to set up Bodybymac, where I wanted to go all chips in,
All chips in, yeah.
Progression, again, I stepped aside, put all my chips in. I didn't have a job. I was a student. I did a little bit of coaching on the side. I thought, let's put all chips in. Let's progress down health and fitness, something that I'm passionate about.
So something that's quite interesting on my side is what you just said there about this. When the passion stops, it stops. Another great intellect, Steve Jobs, says when you can only connect the dots going back. So connecting the dots going back for me was when I was turned 18. I kind of been entrepreneurial for since I was about 13. I was doing a wind around and making money out of whatever I could and in an ethical manner as best I could. But when I turned 18, I love cars. Okay. So I set up a car wash and then got into the tire business and then got into the body shop business and I started making considerable amount of money. Then from there, I would then have every car I could possibly dream of because I had the money, I had a nice place to live, I was driving around in an M3 or an Evo, and I was very living the life of showing off to thinking that would make other people like me, and I ended up being what people would look at as being a complete idiot or a complete dickhead in life, and that's the position I ended up falling into by insecurities. Okay, so then I was just literally all chips in on cars because I loved them. So everything I did was about cars. And all of a sudden one day I got fed up of driving the car and I sold this nice car. And then I was like, now what do I do? I've lost a bit of passion for the cars. And I actually sold in everything in a whim, in about 1 month, simply because I wasn't any more fulfilled by the passion of the cars. So as an entrepreneur, it's quite important to understand where you are, and as a person in life, whether it's not an entrepreneur, it's to understand your passion. And later on, I think in these podcasts, I'll go into how I found that and then how I've helped clients find that as well. And then what I did is I sold and I went traveling. And literally the traveling was supposed to be 1 year. It ended up being several years. And during that traveling time, I was searching for my next passion. But I didn't know I was doing that until I connected dots going back. So it's interesting now that I've gone all chips in on health and fitness for the past, you know, 5-6 odd years, and just do that, and that's what keeps me happy, because I'm progressing towards that goal, you know, empowered by eating. My business with Dean Connor started 4 years ago or so, and of course when you start off any health and fitness business, you just become noise in the 7 billion fitness businesses in the world, when there's only 8 billion people who live here, and there's like seems to be more and more all the time. And I just fell into that, and it took me 3-4 years before I was even heard by anybody. So that's quite interesting. But what drove me through that was passion. I was massively passionate about helping people not make the mistakes that I made, my mum made, the people around me. And that's one of the things that I think has kept me happy. So yeah, that's an interesting thought.
I think that's knowing your want as well, and what you want. Yeah. I mean, I've always been submerged in my training, my education and whatnot. So, you know, I went traveling for, what date did I go? September, I went to Australia. I got a year's visa, and I just thought, well, I might be back next week. I might be back next year. I literally didn't know. Plan was to go out, see a few things, because in my head I needed space, and I wanted to think about, what do I want from this life? What makes me happy? Do I just want to see places and, you know, let's see a bit of the world? So it's what I did, and I was only there for 6 weeks, and then I went to Bali and I had a holiday, and I came back, and I came back because I loved it there, don't get me wrong, but I didn't feel like I was progressing in the way I wanted to progress.
I thought you were going to stay. I did.
Yeah, well, so did I, you know, so did I, seriously. But it's, again, it's that progression. And if I don't feel like I'm progressing, I do get restless. And I know so many entrepreneurs and people in fitness that are the same. So many people, we get restless. And yeah, I could do out there, which I was doing. You know, people say you can't online coach from a beach. Well, guess what, guys? I did it, and it was awesome. But it's,
that's,
you know,
interesting.
But, you know, it's progression. I felt like I could progress more back in the UK. And what made me happy was not sitting on a beach. That didn't make me happy. What made me happy was being closer to my family and being closer to my friends and having that social interaction with people I know and just being close to everything. And that's what made me happy. So I came back.
Yeah.
I'm going to go traveling again. Don't get me wrong. I've got a few trips lined up. But again, it comes down to that progression. So I kind of chase happiness through progress. But health and fitness allows me to express it, really, and again helping others as well. I think I want this kind of passion to come across on others.
Yeah.
So again, coming back to happiness, if a client says to me, you know, I'm struggling, I'm not enjoying this diet, okay, fine, we take a diet break. You're not enjoying things, let's get food high, let's take a diet break. They have a diet break. Okay, Tom, I'm not feeling this diet, I'm tired. Okay, let's stop dieting. You know, there's nothing to say you need to diet.
Yeah.
You know, if you're not dieting for a photo shoot or a show, why the hell are you dieting? You know, you do things.
people get lost in this lose weight, lose weight, lose weight, lose weight mentality.
The island analogy you used earlier.
Yeah.
The forever swimming there.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, when people think they're chasing the abs to just make them happy, abs don't make you happy. I've had abs and, you know, I've been lean and am I happier now at a higher body fat percentage after I've just had a cinnamon swirl? Yes, I'm a lot happier now, because, you know, getting in shape is great. And if that makes you happy, crack on. You know, I'm loving training right now. I'm loving everything about my off season, but it's making me happy. Like I said earlier, if I wake up tomorrow and bodybuilding's not for me and I want to take up ping pong, then I'm going to take up ping pong and I'm going to stop the bodybuilding because I'm chasing that happiness.
Give you a good right arm.
Yeah, well, I'm going to have the arms for it. So
it's sometimes in life, especially around health and fitness and the body, we try to achieve this body or this image that, like, in reality might not be achievable anyway.
Yeah.
But then when we actually dig down, you'll have done it with your clients of yours. When you dig down, it's actually about trying to get happier. It's not about the body.
You peel back the layers and you realize there's a deep underlying issue behind why this person is trying to change themselves so drastically. Yeah.
So sometimes we'll get into deep conversations with clients or when I'm doing a speaking event and I'll be like, why is it you want to lose weight? And no one's ever asked them that. And they go, well, I'll just look better. And I'm like, but why?
Yeah.
Like, is it because you look better for everybody else? And then that brings us to the, conversation between internal and external happiness. And understanding that there is two distinct types of happiness and the world is very much being pushed towards this external happiness through social media, through needing likes on Facebook, through needing external happiness, through people liking what you're doing on social media. So that's a big avenue. And we end up with this. We, as time's progressed, and as I've kind of, this is like my observation of how life has progressed over the last 10 years, we've become very externally motivated through commodity and productivity of the world and marketing and things like that. And we've forgot a lot of internal happiness. Well, not forgot, but people don't understand there's a difference.
Yeah.
So this is something that, for me, took me many years to discover. Was I was living nearly 100% through external happiness, external stimuli. And I like obviously talking about water for some reason by the sounds of it. Maybe it's because I'm Aquarius, I don't know. But I've got another story that I talked about the other day on my Instagram story, was the bath water analogy. So when we're a kid and we're lying in the bath, we want to make waves in the bath sometimes, right? So we flop around. Now, the more you flop around in the bath, the more waves you make. But of course, if you go too hard, some water will pour out the side. So the analogy here is that that's a little bit of internal happiness coming out of the bath. So the more we flap around, the more waves we make, the more water pours out of the bath. So obviously, you've got to push harder and harder and harder while you're playing in the bath to make more water. And the more you push, the more water flings out the bath. And the adult's telling you off, who's supposed to be looking after you. And you keep going more to try and get more waves, but you can't because you're kind of running out of water, which is like running out of internal happiness. And this is like the analogy of trying to get happiness from external stimuli. The more we push, the less able we are to keep the happiness going. So the kind of story then progresses to when you're an adult. If you're an adult and you lie in a bath, what do? You know not to move too much because the water will fling out.
So you've got to tidy up.
You've got to tidy up yourself, and you're going to make the bathroom wet. And if you slip in the bath and it pours, you're like, whoa, because you're going to flip it right off. And you know you don't mess about, you don't make waves, you just lie there. And what do? You just enjoy the bath, which means we should just enjoy living in life because we're lucky being here. So that's kind of like, that's how we should just, that's like in a story, just to see how these external stimuli can kind of affect your life. And imagine if you're doing that over and over and over and you're looking for these things that make you happy on a daily basis, like sex, like drugs, like alcohol, like sweet food, like chocolate, like cake, like the nice meal out, you know, these type of stimuli. The more we try to get of that, it might be going on holiday, it might be jumping out of an aeroplane, it might be bungee jumping, it might be going more and more and more and more to the point where when you're not doing something, you're not happy. So we look for this stimuli all the time. And that is like the external stuff. So then we've got to try and, at some point, we've got to try and break that external stimuli. I mean, it's okay to have them. I mean, you must have external stimuli goals yourself.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, This is quite a good story, actually. I was in Bali, and if anyone's ever been to Bali, it's, you know, if you're on a beach resort, then it's great. You know, it's such a nice place. But if you see the poverty there that goes on, you know, it's quite disturbing. And I mean, I was walking home. I'd already kind of accepted fate that I was coming back to the UK. And I was walking home in a thunderstorm. I was wearing lovely clothes, not blowing smoke up my ass, but, you know, they weren't cheap. And I was thinking, right, okay, before I left for Australia, I sold my car, when I got back to the UK, I know I had to get a place. I was going to move out with mum and dad. And I was planning all these things in my head. I was planning what car I can get, which apartment, what area am I going to try and get. And I'm thinking of all these things. And there's this little girl walking down the street. And it's a thunderstorm. It's absolutely pouring down. Torrential rain. And I'm walking back. And there's no parents around. She just wants money. And the exchange rate over there is crazy. Everything's so cheap. And I walked off. And this beggar girl, she's begging every day. So I walked past, not thinking anything of it. And then something just clicked. And I came back, and this girl's, you know, wearing rags. She's begging on the street. She's on her own. It's pouring down. There's cars everywhere. I give her some money, and it probably wasn't even £5, probably a lot less. And the look she gave me, like no one that day, or she'd never even seen money before. And that, to me, you know, it sounds cliche. I'm no saint, and I'm not claiming to be, but that was actually priceless. I didn't even know the girl, but that was priceless. I came back to my hotel. Everything I hadn't worn on that trip, we put in a bin bag, and I left it in the hotel for the cleaning staff to just use for their families. And then I thought, you know, whatever car I buy isn't going to make me happy. I've got a lovely car outside. I'm sitting in a gorgeous apartment, but none of these things make me happy. Again, it's coming back to that progress. That's what makes me happy, because that's internal happiness. Doing that gesture, that goodwill I did that day, that made me happy. That made me more happier than lying on the beach earlier that afternoon coaching. So
this is one of the reasons why I wanted to ask you to come on this podcast, was because it's some people in life go through their entire life up until their 50s not knowing the difference between internal and external happiness. And it's quite sad to see many people in life living through the external stimuli and trying to be happy through TV, through doing things that are going to make them happy and not getting the internal stuff. And what you've just said there is exactly why I asked you to come on here, is because you're 22 years old and you get it. When I was 22 years old, I was living 100% trying to get happiness through external stimuli, and I didn't get it. So that's quite fascinating to actually speak to you getting it now and realizing that there's the outlet of personal development and learning that people can go through now in this day and age, and it's only 10 years. Like, I didn't know anything about personal development. I didn't, audible.com didn't exist. I'm dyslexic myself, so I hate reading, so there's no chance of me reading a book. So then when that came about, I've had an Audible membership for, you know, as long as I can remember, and I'm on about 200 books or so far, mostly around personal development, because I realized my brain was broken. So it's fascinating looking at you and seeing that 22 you're personally developed, or you've done a lot of self-help for yourself by mistake, whether you've done that on purpose. What have you done? Have you done anything on purpose?
To be honest, it's all this information, you know, that we can Google anything these days. Like we spoke about on our podcast, you can Google anything, and information's there if you want to learn it. If you want to sit there and watch reality TV, don't get me wrong, I like a good episode of X on the Beach. But, you know, if you want to sit there and consume all that media, then so be it. If that's what makes you happy. But if you want to progress and you want to look at how you can improve your physique, your mindset, your business, your relationships, then you need to dig a little bit deeper, stop peeling back the layers. And
what is it that you did? Did you read some books, or did you listen to some books, or did you?
To be honest, mate, you know, I've got a good bookshelf. I have got a lot of books, but I don't read that much. It's more through podcasts and listening to people that I look up to, and I think more life experiences.
Okay.
Again, just along the way and realizing what you want. I'll tell the listeners what was really going to make them happy. Or the viewers, is social interaction. That's what's going to make you happy, I think, overall.
Especially now with social media taking over and people not realizing they're getting stuck.
They're
scrolling on the phone, and they're in social environments when they could be interacting and they're scrolling on the phone.
They take it for granted, just that ease of access. I mean, even in kind of like in the, when I was doing my show prep in 2016, I didn't enjoy it. And it came to a point where I actually pulled out of my prep, and not many people know this. Me, my coach, a few of my friends, I pulled out. And I don't know if you knew it or I even told you, but I pulled out and I wasn't enjoying it. I was in great shape, but I knew that I could have been better and I wasn't willing to give it any more. So I didn't see that progression from I had expected myself, what I wanted for myself, and it did make me happy. I pulled out and I was getting all these external compliments. Oh, you're looking great. I posted some pictures up on Facebook. 100 likes or whatever, you know, you're looking great, when's the show? And it spurred me on, but still, because that's external feedback, but in the back of my mind, something wasn't right. And that internal happiness wasn't there. You know, I did the show and then I said, that's it. I'm not doing the British finals. I'm not doing another show because it didn't make me happy deep down. It's a passion, but at that time, it didn't make me happy. So, like I said to you, a point I alluded to earlier is if I wake up tomorrow and I don't enjoy this, it stops.
Yeah.
And as soon as I finished prep, I spent more time with my friends, had more social interaction, life got a lot better.
Yeah.
I was happier day to day. And that's from internal happiness. That's not external. That's not chasing the likes, the social.
So what's really interesting here is to speak to you and you haven't purposely gone on out there like I had to and listen to books. When I say read, I mean listen to books and listen to self-help books and personal development. For you, it's been the gym where you've been. You've found that hitting a gym and, you know, progressing in that mindset, eating right and getting your nutrition on point.
Yeah.
Progressing around all of that and obviously now business as well has made you naturally happy without needing to do the self-help as much as I have. And that's fascinating for me to look at and listen. There's another reason why I wanted to get you on first of all as well. But this internal happiness thing, or this learning of internal happiness thing, sounds boring. It sounds a bit hippie. It sounds a bit like I've got to do work. And trying to move from this internal happiness internal happiness away from the external stuff, because the external stuff sounds exciting and sounds amazing, but then if you really deep down think about it, when you've had the external stuff, you become unhappy. So the idea is that you have the external stuff, you enjoy that, but understand that it's not the be-all and end-all of life because you've got your internal happiness things as well. So to try and break that, we end up being... because we're addicted to these external happiness things. Like, we need the TV. I've not watched TV for about 8 or 9 years personally, apart from movies. But we need the TV as a society. We need the chocolate and the cakes and the holiday once or twice a year. We need that to be happy. So it's hard to break the idea because we're addicted to that. Because, of course, that makes the world go round and makes people earn money. So I think... for me, chasing these internal happiness goals for all these years kind of helped me break it, because I did a lot and I did everything I possibly wanted. I was jumping off mountains on my snowboard for 6 months of the year and
escapism.
Yeah, that's it. So then for me, it was like, why am I not always happy if I'm doing all these awesome things? So that was kind of that. And then as I started working on personal development, I kind of found this. More confidence, but in a controlled manner, not where I was hiding my inner insecure self. I was beginning to learn about happiness, and I was like developing this inner peace. And the problem is, it can't be bought, and you can't go and just get it. You have to work on it, and you have to work on the inside of your mind to make sure that you're living life to the highest possible quality. And then when you try to explain this to some people, because the world is so fixated around external stimuli, external happiness, it's like a drug, that it's hard to even explain what's going on inside somebody who's got deep internal happiness and is just happy all the time. But then, of course, because they're not and you are happy, they're like, well, why is he happy every day? And that kind of becomes a problem as well. So we have to try and get past that and explain it on a different manner. So what's interesting, like you said before, was this about people searching for the image change to make them happy.
Yeah.
And there are studies that show, I mean, obviously it's hard to study psychology compared to how black and white nutrition should be, because that's most of our focus. Personal development and psychology is very, very opinionated. It's really interesting to be able to maybe take what you said before about the Google searching for any information as well. It's like we can Google search personal development and be overwhelmed by the comeback of all the stuff that's on there. So it's like, it's interesting for me to have consumed all of this personal development stuff. And I think through this podcast, give it in a different spin and hopefully give access to a different way of looking at personal development without having to Google it. But the study shows that the self-image, people who are searching to change their self-image are less happy in a full-time manner compared to people that have become happy with their self-image. Yeah. So the idea would be to become happy with your self-image before you try to change your image, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, definitely.
So when I started out, when I was your age, maybe a little bit younger, maybe about 20, I was taking every potion and pill I could get from the supplement shop, every method I could choose to try and get that body of my dreams, thinking that when people look at my body, they will like me more. And that's kind of where I was.
Yeah.
Then you go on holiday and you've got a six pack and it doesn't mean absolutely nothing because, you know, people are less focused on you than you think. And that's a big topic of what we'll talk about in other podcasts. Then further to go onto these external goals, external motivation again is there's more studies again from different books that show that people who have got money goals or even survival money goals, so people who are trying to survive in life through money, are less likely to be happy on an ongoing basis compared to people who don't have a goal for money, which is what you said before about the giving. They have more goals towards the giving in life or progressing towards their passion. So we end up needing money and thinking it makes us happy. Now I know, because when I was back doing the businesses, I had too much money for my own good and I just spent it on cars and holidays and I wasn't happy probably 70% of the time, but 30% of the would, because I'd be excited towards the holiday, I was excited for the next car I was going to buy. And that's kind of where I was. A lot of studies around external stimuli show that happiness isn't achievable long term. So then obviously the next thing would be to go, so how do we get this internal happiness thing where we're always happy? And we'll talk about that in the next episode. No, I'm only joking. We'll go a little bit into it now.
I was just ready to fire as well.
Because everyone's like, what?
Okay, so this is what I do with clients, okay? First of all, on my coaching phone, they're always going to ask, you know, what's your goal? Why is your goal? That's going to be the first question we start working together. You know, why do you want to do this? And if their goal is to just kind of, those that have got kids, put it that way, those that are obese, let's should we say, or they've got, they're really overweight, they are the best clients because they're coming at it from a kind of, they have to do this yes. to improve their life because it is affecting their life. But if it's just someone that, you know, maybe has 5 pounds to lose, they're usually the ones that maybe doing late check-ins, maybe cutting corners here or there because it's not their want, you know, it's not their big goal, which may be happiness, like someone who's overweight severely, that's affecting their life. Mm. So you need to really think, what is your want? And is that really going to make you happy? If it's improving your health or longevity for you, you know, to be there for your kids, that's obviously a motivating factor. It's going to make you happy. If it's to get shredded for Ibiza, probably, you know, it's not that important to you. So if that's going to make you happy, and it really is, then continue. But for the most part, it's going to be something deep down is the reason why you want to lose weight. Mm. So, for example, those that binge eating is not because, you know, sugar tastes great, but that's not the fact and that's not the cause of obesity. The cause of obesity, one of the causes anyway, is just unhappiness, like day to day, like we said about escapism, it's escapism. So if you've got shit relationships, if you can't socialize properly, if you're a recluse, if you're missing that someone in your life, then that is all going to have a knock-on effect and it's dominoes. So
sometimes, sometimes people can, like the word recluse can be thrown out there, but sometimes it's not the fault of the person, it's the fault of this overall external stimuli life going on for them. And then they become more and more into a depressive state to the point where they end up not going out of the house because they feel so low. And it's like something like this podcast might just bring a couple of them people out. And that was one of my internal happiness goals, is to be able to help someone who's in that state. Because obviously depression can be clinically diagnosed and it's a state which is a very dark place, and sometimes medication is given, but sometimes a depressive state, not depression, but a depressive state can be caused by simply needing to learn more about this internal versus external happiness or stimuli.
yeah,
and a bit of personal development. So this might just be one person might just get, you know, five episodes in and might be like, oh, I'm feeling that a lot better now because I've learned in a different way. And this listening to us is actually learning rather than the fear of university and books and listening to audiobooks might be a bit too much for some people. So this is like a lighthearted way of getting a message across. And I think that's absolutely amazing.
You need to find what's not making you happy and solve it.
Yeah. It takes work for some people.
So like, you need to get harsh with yourself. You know, there's probably aspects of my life that I need to improve on, but I'm aware of them and I'm going to make steps to try and improve them.
Yeah.
And find that, because what you'll often find is you may be overeating, you may be wanting to lose weight for them reasons, not for the reasons you think.
Yeah.
And it's down to internal happiness. You're chasing all these external things, the likes on Instagram, you're chasing the ads, you're chasing the cover model body. When it might come down to you're lonely, you're overeating because you're in a depressive state. Yeah. That's why you've gone that way and you think that's going to solve all your problems. And
what you said before was quite interesting about the client or the person that needs to lose a lot of weight versus the person that doesn't need to lose a lot of weight. So, for example, I had a client recently, not recently, it's actually been about a year and a half, who's lost over 100 pounds.
Yeah.
And then all the way through it, she was in a quite happy state. And then obviously she's got to the end of her goals. And now we're working on a lot of this happiness stuff and a lot of personal development, because to get her to the next bit, which is only about another 20 pounds before she's not probably classed as obese anymore. So it's like now we're working a lot around this, and I'm sending her audio books and she's loving this personal development lifestyle. And it's not even about weight loss anymore. It's about progressing the mind. But she didn't need that when she had 100 pounds to lose, because that was a huge, she must lose that weight type feeling.
Yeah, that was external. Yeah. That was external, internal motivator. Yeah.
So you can almost let that person be massively externally stimulated for quite a long time. And then when that runs out, you kind of then turning the dial a little bit and giving different types of motivation, which is then going inside the head and changing things that the mindset and the way they're thinking. So I came up with a bit of a list about what can help develop this internal motivations and kind of what they are. So it was about trying to pursue physical exercise, you know, whatever that may be, whether it go into a gym where it's got a good community feel. So the gym then has a lot of people that you can make friends with, like you said before. So that becomes
social
aspect of it. It's creating, or something I'll do later on, I'm going to get someone to help or talk about this bit, is creating a mindset and an internal way of living to be able to find that partner who you can then be deeply in love with. Not just the first 6 months, but properly, you know, connected with, and there's deep energy there. So it's about finding that person. We've already spoke about this. The next thing was learning and education, which is however you decide to do that, like a podcast, but then being progressive through that and just carrying on going and enjoying the learning process. The next thing, which we both do, is finding flow state. So some people call flow state different ways, but finding a state of life where you're in flow. So we're in flow now because we're just loving talking about this bit. You're in flow when you're helping your clients and when you're in the gym and when you're training. And it's finding parts of your life where you're not trying. Another one was kindness. We've already said about that. Giving. There's studies around that. People who give more happen to be more internally happy. So personally, and Tom does the same thing as well, actually. We just give as much as we can, and you'll see that on social media. And it's perceived as being a bit weird because we just keep giving all information, and some people don't get why we're doing it and they get a bit skeptical about it. But we're just simply giving it because it makes us feel happier inside. Gratitude. Some people will say wake up every morning and think about three things that you're happy about. Integrity, and this is quite important to work on, which we'll talk about in a later subject, is being authentic and being who you are, the same person you are when you're lying in bed as you are talking in front of 50 people. You've got to be the same person.
Yeah.
And then this is something that's relevant for both me and Tom, is contribution. So you're helping other people, but we've both got Facebook groups, and in these Facebook groups, other people who have been my client have learned this contribution bit where they're giving to other people for no reason. They're just commenting on other people's stuff to help them progress through Tom's coaching, through the Empowered by Eating plan, and they're helping each other. So they're getting their own internal happiness by helping other people. And then to finish off, I'd like to kind of, if you've been listening to this and you've enjoyed it, is to go away and perhaps sit down with yourself on your own in a quiet room and write down your goals, because some people, this was something that changed my life dramatically about 8 years ago, was someone saying to me, what are your goals? It was my brother, in fact, and he set me off on this personal development lifestyle where I've been learning nonstop. It would be to sit down, write down your goals, but don't write down your goals in just, I want to do this, I want to do that. Write them down and split them into internal and external goals. So what would be one of your external goals, Tom?
External, off the top of my head, I can only think internal right now, because it's kind of all we've kind of chat about. In terms of what's going to make me happy, what's going to make me happy is growing my business.
Okay, so this would be internal, but if you've talked about money, it would be external.
External would be growing my business, but then if I had to say what overall is going to make me happy is simply progression, and that's not just in business, that's in everything.
Yeah.
And that's social interaction and developing relationships, and what these all come down to is progression, fitness, bodybuilding, this eating good, you know.
Yeah.
This health and fitness lifestyle has allowed me to express progression, and I think that is what exercise, health and fitness, bodybuilding has done for me.
Yeah, and it's like, so if these guys are sitting there now and they want to write down their own, it would be to something like split a piece of A4 paper in half on the top.
Internal, external.
And at the bottom, external. And write them down on purpose and go, like, one of my external goals would be, for example, to buy one of the cars that I used to have when I had good money, and I want to buy an M3. So I understand it's an external goal, and it doesn't mean much, it's just a small goal. And then to write down my internal goals, which are huge, and it's more about doing what we're doing here, is helping people. And then you can see the difference of what they are then, and you'll realize... Yeah. Most people will realize most of the goals would fall into external. So then you have to then develop on the internal goals, which is what we'll do in the next few podcasts. So we call it there, and that's all for me and Tom. It's been absolutely awesome. Hope you've enjoyed listening to us. Tom's given a great outlook on internal happiness and how he's done it. So you've been listening to Tom Mack and Chris Ellerby-Hemmings, and I hope that we've helped you empower your body, mind, and life a little bit better today. Thank you, guys.